Hello guys, welcome back to my channel, Brian the Floridian, coming to you from Clearwater, or more specifically, actually, right on the edge of Clearwater, right here near this little town called Dunedin, Florida, which is a Gulf Coast town, probably one of the biggest towns here in Pinellas County, Florida, but pretty cool place. If you want to check it out, I actually know this place, and I wanted to go ahead and film some locations around here, but I want you guys to join me. Let's go take a look. Follow me. So right down Edgewater Drive is the sign that welcomes you right here to Dunedin. Pretty cool sign. There's a little Scottish piper right there on the left side of the sign. And it says right there, home of the pipe band champions, 2018 World Grade 2. Pretty cool sign right here on Clearwater Harbor. So guys, this place was established in 1852. It was actually called Jonesboro by a gentleman named George Jones, who was an area mercantile around this area. And later, two Scottish gentlemen that lived here that applied for the first post office named this place Dunedin, which really is a Scottish word for Edinburgh, which is the capital city of Scotland. So pretty cool history. And at one time, this was a huge training center here in Florida. This place had the largest fleet of sailing vessels here at one time in Florida. So really big, huge training post here. So it's just more than just a little tourist trap. It's actually a training post here in Florida, which is pretty cool, reading back history. But let's go take a look down the street here. Let's go down to downtown Dunedin and take a closer look and see what's going on down here. And you guys follow me. So guys, I just parked here downtown Dunedin. I'm just gonna take a walk around and see what we can see here. And I saw that there's a festival happening down right here down on the main street here. And that's where I'm walking to. So let's go take a look and follow me, guys. So guys, one of the first things I found right here, right on the side of this restaurant, is these little dogs here. A bunch of paintings of dogs. And there are names here too. It's a whole wall of this artwork here. There's some hibiscus flowers right there. But pretty interesting, look at this. Let's take a closer look and see what we can find right here. So I know Dunedin's a very dog-friendly city. As you can tell from there, there's people walking their dog over there. So pretty interesting looking artwork. And this place is called the living room, which is a restaurant. And there's even a little mural for this southeastern guide dogs. So definitely a lot of dogs murals here in Dunedin. Very dog friendly city here. So right on the side of PC's Sushi and Global Pastry is this cool looking mural right there too. So definitely a lot of Scottish references here to the city of Dunedin, like this bagpiper right here, right inside this building, and it's advertising for Dunedin Realty. So you'll see like a lot of this stuff around Dunedin. So right here at the top of Main Street is the Dunedin City Hall. Sitting from that sign, and right there is City Hall. Pretty small. What's interesting here is this old school barbershop called McGuire's Barbershop, and they're only open for appointments only. But definitely old school looking side. So one of these things you see along this road is a lot of these signs that say advertising dog friendly outdoor dining. So definitely a reason why that dog mural back there was there, because this is definitely a dog friendly city, as you can tell right over there with that gentleman with his dog. Probably gonna go in that cafe to eat back and relax, maybe have a lunch. So right here outside of City Hall is a sign saying that this Dunedin actually is a city to Stirling, Scotland, and also Summerside, Prince Edward Island. And there's the seal of Dunedin right there. What's crazy are these big oak trees right there. They're just everywhere right here along the street, especially right here in front of City Hall. And this guy is actually being held by a cable to keep it together. And these things go way up there. And here's the oak tree I was looking at. It says right on the placard, Dunedin's grand old oak tree, and this thing is about 100 years old. So we're going south down Main Street, and there is a lot of little shops right here on the left and right. There's even a hot dog place right there, which is really, really delicious from what I hear, called Main Street Hot Dogs. But all along this sidewalk is just brick. Definitely very walking friendly here. That is a very nice looking dog bakery right there called Wolfgang Bakery and Grooming. Looks pretty spacious inside there. But here, that is sitting right catty corner to the living room, which had the dog murals right there on the side of the building. And there's the front of the building right there. Here's another shot of Main Street right here in front of the living room. And over there is this sushi place. It says Welcome Back Blue Jays. So this is a training home of the Dunedin Blue Jays, and they're actually playing here until Canada opens up because of the pandemic. But here's a little park right next to me. Interesting little park with these cool looking statues. There's a bench right there if you want to just kind of chill out and relax. So guys, there's an old school trolley stop right here, but there is an old school trolley that actually goes right down Main Street. Right down and drops you off these little shops along here. And hopefully I'll catch a glimpse of it. Speaking of the trolley, it's right there, coming right down the road here. right outside Flanagan's Irish Pub is this little wine bar, which is, I think, pretty cool. Doesn't seem to be open right now, but right here off the main drag, and right next to that is a bunch of these more of these pet murals. And they're just everywhere. Yeah, they're just painted on every block, seems like it. Dogs and cats. And right here, right next to that pet mural is another mural right here on the side of the storefront. Looks like some kind of Spanish conquistador right there. Interesting looking mural with a snake up in the tree. There's an apple up there. Looks like a kid running away from the horseman right there. A couple pigs in top hats. And this interesting look poem right here. I'm not going to read it, but I'll show you guys. Pretty cool. So outside Christie's International Real Estate is this little lighthouse, which I found very interesting. And these two chairs right there, these Arundock chairs. And there's a little beach scene right on the side of the building. And right on the sand dunes are more, it's like more canines, more dogs right there. I'm assuming these are dogs that people maybe owned in the past, or maybe owned or own right now. But pretty cool. So there's some kind of festival here, right here in downtown Dunedin. There's the stage that's always here. And we're right in the parking lot of Dennis, and one of the things I wanted to point out is this cool sign. It's right in front of me. It says, Dennis office parking only. All others will be extracted. That's pretty clever. Looks like some kind of art festival going on right here. There's the front of the stage right there. Definitely a lot happening here, right here in downtown Dunedin. So reading one of the signs right there, they have a market right here in downtown Friday and Saturday. It's called the Dunedin Downtown Market. It's right here at John Lawrence Pioneer Park, which had the stage back there. But all these merchants, many of these merchants are here on Friday and Saturday. So as a lot of places around Florida, there's these little free libraries around. And Dunedin is no exception. There's one right here on the side of the church, but there's many of these around the whole city. And they're definitely utilized because there's books in there that are being constantly removed and put in place. So I find this really amazing right here. Look at this building right here, right? This is called Skip's Bar. And it even says, welcome to Dog Eden. And look at all those dogs here. Some of the dogs have halos on them, which I imagine are dogs that passed. But there's not just dogs, there's cats, birds on here. Pretty cool. I just find this really, really cool and amazing. And it just goes on and on down, right down this wall. Now that is cool. So So definitely this place is happening. Look at this, downtown Dunedin. Lots of seating outside. Very tourist friendly here. So it even says right there, welcome back Blue Jays. And this is the actual midpoint of Main Street. This trail right here is actually the Pinellas Trail, which is a bike trail that goes along the whole Pinellas County. As you can see, the guy riding his bike right there. And there's actually a walking post. And here's looking down south along the Pinellas Trail. And here's another free library with oranges right on the outside of it, painted really nice. Nice touch. Definitely a lot of people out and about today walking along. And over there is Cafe Alfresco, which is a pretty popular eatery here in Dunedin. And right here is the Main Street Museum for Dunedin. So right here is a sign for the Dunedin Museum of History and station stop. And Lane's Lemonade, which is right back behind me, that caboose. But what's cool is like these little statues right here. Right over there is a dolphin, and you'll see these around downtown Dunedin. As well as this guy right here in front of the museum, this train conductor. He's calling to say that the train is taking off. And this lady and her child are basically hurrying to get on the train. So this museum is a history of Dunedin. And one of the first things you walk into is this pig statue. It says the reason why Dunedin's being free roaming hogs were turning the town upside down. But also a lot of information about Dunedin, all the way from the earliest times to like the present. So the Tobago Indians were actually here first in this area of Florida. And then the Spaniards came here. But some really cool old pictures of Dunedin. It's pretty cool looking safe from the Bank of Dunedin. So that sign right here talks about the pig problems here in Dunedin. Hence the statue when you first walk in.
they were actually a problem in 1899. And this talks about a little bit about what they had to do for getting rid of the loose hogs here.
Interesting.
So George Jones was this gentleman right there, and he was actually one of the first pioneers of Dunedin. And this was actually called Jonesboro at one time before it became Dunedin. So this one talks about the famous residents of Dunedin right there. About how it became a destination for vacation. And there's this little interactive thing. You can kind of like push this. And you can kind of learn about the history of the residents that live here in Dunedin. But definitely pretty cool. Talks about the warm temperatures and proximity to the water, which made it a perfect tourist destination. So definitely a lot of history, cool history here in this museum about Dunedin. There's this little sailboat right here. There was actually boat clubs here. Right here in this little town. And this talks about another place right here outside of Dunedin called Honeymoon Island, which actually was a big, I believe they call it Hog Island at one time. And a hurricane split it in two, according to this sign right here, and made it into Caladese Island and Honeymoon Island. So pretty cool history here. Looks like a 1920s attire right there. Talks about the Honeymoon Island. Which Honeymoon Island was actually a big time destination for newlyweds. Hence the name for Honeymoon Island. And there is the bell from the wedding chapel. A lot of great history here. And also a lot of great pictures too of what it looked like back in the day. Lots of history in here about the little parks around Dunedin. Weaver Park, which is down the road, and Hammock Park. And also, this talks about the sports, particularly the Dunedin Blue Jays that play at Grant Park or Grant Field. Listen up. So let's go ahead and push one of these buttons here and hear about the history of Dunedin.
The opportunity seemed to be implied that the family at Milwaukee Corporation financed them. The family put in $25 a month to come to Florida, buy land, and plant oranges, which he did with gusto. He had food coming in by about.
My maiden name was Sybil Rousseau. I was born in Manatee County at the little town of Omico, July 14th.
So definitely citrus was a big part of the Dunedin. As you can tell from the history of these little placards right here. So this is actually a little information about Skinner Machinery Company, which was a manufacturing packing house. Many orange groves right here in Pinellas County. a little bit of information about the packing house. There's the old picture of what it looked like back in the early times. Definitely a nice little museum. Actually, this whole room right here is dedicated to the citrus industry here in Dunedin, Florida. A little bit of history about the packing industry here, also when they actually stored and concentrated orange juice here. Lots of cool interactive displays here, which is really interesting. And this talks about the old railroad museum that was here, the train station. Interesting, Peter Demens built the first railroad through Dunedin in 1888 as part of the Orange Belt Railway that stretched from Sanford to St. Pete. There's an old conductor uniform right there in front of us. More about the railroad here. And Robert Boy was the Dunedin's longest running station master. So out looking at this window is what it would look like back in early part of 1920s or 30s. And there's an old train right there. So this used to be an old train station. And there's the passengers right there. It's pretty cool. Here's some info about the telegraph, which they use for communication for the railroad. An old phone, some old instruments back in the day. There's some train tools right in front of me here. Some more oranges. And like many small towns, it talks about the death of downtown, about what happened. All the big box stores opening up and then how this place got revitalized from the tourist industry. And I was talking to one of the ladies here that works in the museum, and she said that there is a lot of these orange murals around Dunedin, and they were actually painted by a couple of people, Stephen Spathoff and Marcia Goines. So they secretly painted them in 2009, right in the middle of the night, and they basically just took off before the sun came up. All over Dunedin there's these little images of oranges, and they were responsible for painting those. and also talks about the Scottish connection here to Dunedin. Which talks about being founded by Scottish immigrants. So James Somerville and J.O. Douglas actually named the town, got the name for Dunedin, which actually comes from the name of Edinburgh, which was like the original capital of Scotland, I believe. Pretty cool history here. So there's actually a hurricane area here. It talks about the hurricanes that came through Tampa Bay. I imagine, especially Dunedin. Really interesting here. So talking to one of the ladies that works here, she said this was probably the deadliest hurricane that came through Tampa Bay, 1921, and it actually split one of the islands in the two parts, which was Caladese and Honeymoon Island. At the time, it was called Hog Island. So one of the most deadliest hurricanes that come through here, for sure. It's another little exhibit about things unique in Dunedin. What's cool right here is they have an interactive display you can touch. Let's try that. Huh, I was right. Pretty cool. So here's the gift shop of the Dunedin Welcome Center. Pretty cool. Bunch of history books right here on the area. From Lane's Lemonade. Right underneath the clock tower. Pretty cool. So Lane's Lemonade is built off an old caboose right on the train tracks here.
where they used to be right here in Dunedin, right down there. So used to come down here with the thin train tracks. And there's a museum that we were just at right over there. Well, here's a little winning place. I'm just waiting for my lemonade to show up. Just ordered, just ready to have it picked up. They're making it right now. So guys, got my lemonade right here from Lane's Lemonade. I'll take a sip. Oh man, so good. Fresh squeezed lemonade, awesome. On a warm day like this. Can't go wrong with something like this. Good, very, very good. So heading right down Main Street, coming down these, down the very end, just saw this cool looking golf cart right here. It's like a combination tiki golf cart. That's pretty cool. So there's definitely a golf cart city here. A lot of people are driving golf carts around downtown Dunedin. But just couldn't help notice this little golf cart right here, right parked right off the main thoroughfare. Right in front of Tony's Pizza. But as you go down more west is the waterfront right down there. So right here on the corner of Main Street and Broadway is this archway defending freedom, honoring Captain Morgan Gagnon, US Air Force. Pretty cool tribute. Especially for a small town honoring a service member. But Broadway just goes down this way. There's more eateries down there, more coffee shops, but definitely a pretty cool area to explore, walk around for taking the sights and sounds. And there's a telephone booth right there, old school telephone booth, looks like from England or something like that, but other than that, but looking up, what's even interesting more about that is this thing on the side of the building here. These statues going right up the ladder right there. The shot of the statues, but that's an interesting looking artwork right there. So guys, I'm gonna get some lunch because I've been walking around for a little bit here in downtown Dunedin, and there's one special place that I just saw right here off the Main Street. Probably the smallest taco bar I have ever seen anywhere, or taco stand. And I hear they got the most excellent street tacos around. So right over here off Main Street is Taco Baby Street Tacos. And it's this little joint right here, right off the side of this building right there. Probably the smallest taco stand I've seen anywhere. But there's some tables back there to eat. And I'm gonna take a quick peek at the menu and see if I can order something right here. And that's their menu, Taco Baby menu right there. Pretty simple menu, but man, looks really good. How's it going? Order right here? Okay. So here's what we're dealing with right here. I got the Al Pastor street taco, which is I believe pork and pineapple salsa, and also the Tinga, which is roasted chicken and corn salsa. So a couple tacos, a couple choices. The menu is pretty small, so not too much to choose from, but definitely want to check it out. And I got me some mineral water, so let's take a bite and see how these taste. All right, guys, take a taste here of this mineral water, because it's really hot in Florida. Oh man, definitely refreshing, but definitely let's come here what we came here for, which is the street tacos. And I'm gonna try the, I believe this is the El Pastor, which is the pork and the pineapple salsa. Mmm, that is good. Very good. Mmm. Let me try out a bite of the, I believe the chicken, I can't remember the name of it, with the corn salsa. Mmm. That one's better. I think that's probably the best one. That is one of the best tacos I've ever tried in a while. Mmm. Definitely. Check this place out. Baby Taco right here off of Main Street, Dunedin. Excellent stuff. Excellent tacos. So it seems like every town has a little clock downtown. Here's no exception for Dunedin. There's this clock right here on the corner of Main Street and Broadway, right in front of the ice cream place, Stretchin's, where you can get your, where you can come and cool off and get a little treat. And also there's a nice park right next to it right here. Definitely a flurry of activity going on right around here. But I just want to show you guys this veterans monument. Which is a dedication for the recipient of the Purple Heart. Pretty cool. So this is called Purple Heart Park, and that's why they had the monument behind me. But man, this was dedicated August 7, 2008, and it is the nation's first Purple Heart city, which is here in the city of Dunedin. And that is what it looks like looking out. Just a nice dedication. So here's a sign right next to the Pinellas Trail. And it says Florida Greenways and Trails, Trail Town. And that is definitely one thing about Dunedin. There's a lot of trails here. This is the Pinellas Trail, which is a bike trail, which goes that way, north and south down Pinellas County. It's a really cool town. You can ride your bike here in the downtown. Have a bite to eat at Al Fresco if you want to. Really interesting downtown. So one thing about Dunedin, they're celebrating high school graduation, college and high school. And I just saw this on a light pole right here. So that's pretty cool. Little toy fishing pole there. Just a nice small town touch to the graduates that live here in Dunedin. So this is like the weirdest bus I have ever seen right here in Dunedin. Right off Main Street. I'm not sure what this is, but it says AVA, Autonomous Vehicle Advantage. So here is something you hardly ever see, which is an actual car parked right on top of another regular car. In this case, a Hummer with a buggy on top of it. It's like a Jeep. And that is, not sure how far they can drive with this thing on top, but imagine if you had to do it on top of a vehicle, it would be a Hummer. Something really durable like that. So a very popular restaurant right here on the waterfront called Bon Appetit. And it's right in this Best Western Plus Hotel. And it's just right around the corner. Let's go take a look. So it seems like every town you go to, there's always a mural with the town letters outside with a little bit of artwork. In this case, Dunedin right there, and they always welcome you. Pretty cool. Pretty cool little mural right here on this outside of Best Western Plus Hotel, which is right here on the waterfront. Right next to the marina, right over there. I just love this walkway right here in the shape of a fish. Looks like this fish skeleton right over here to cross the road. And we are at the marina right now for Dunedin. And right to the left of me is Old Bay Cafe, which is a popular dive or any kind of food for seafood. It's right there. And they do have some outdoor seating right there. But here's the marina. And plenty of places where you can rent a boat, go fishing, dolphin watching, maybe camping. As we are saying right here. Pretty cool. So here's another one of those famous dolphins around Dunedin, these little sculptures. These colorful painted dolphins. Pretty cool, right outside the restaurant, Bon Appetit. And it's right over there. But what's really cool is this little public dock or pier you can kind of walk down and go fishing if you wanted to at night or during the day. So over there is Bon Appetit, right there on the waterfront. And right across from me is a place I believe you can eat out there too, or maybe have a wedding out there. But there's a little one of those colorful dolphins right on the edge of that dock. But look at the tables there. You can eat along the waterway, which is a pretty good ambience right there. I imagine the views at night would be spectacular in the evening while you're having dinner right over there. But let me show you guys the Clearwater Harbor. This is what we're looking at right here. There's some sailboats right there, docked right in the bay or in the harbor. Not really sure if it's really a harbor or a bay. I think it's a harbor, because the bay itself would be going out that way, which would be Tampa Bay. So another free library right here on the pier. This one's a little bit decorated. A little bit of a fish on top, pretty cool. And there are books in there, inside there, so. Definitely a cool little town to visit, Dunedin, Florida. So another shot of the Old Bay Cafe right in the front. And there's a seating where you can sit out there and enjoy lunch or dinner. Just normal, quick thoroughfare. Right on the edge of the marina right there. But here is Edgewater Park, which we're going to be kind of walking through and taking a look over here. So right here in Edgewater Park is this little monument. Kind of reminds me of the Monument of States in Kissimmee, right on, I believe, right on off of Main Street in Kissimmee, but this is right here in Dunedin. And this has a few states right there. I believe some of the stones are from the states, just like the one in Kissimmee, but pretty cool. There's a smaller version of it. And it's right here on the edge of Edgewater Park, no pun intended, but. I would say most of the states are listed right here. And this one says New Mexico. Very small writing right there. So right more toward the center of Edgewater Park is this right here, all these trees. Nothing really much to see, but man, it's a really nice park. Little gazebo right there. but lots of walking trails right here along the park. Actually very nice here. Hampson Park. It's a very small park right here in the corner. Right here in the corner of Alternate 19 and Main Street in Eden. But there is a nice little fountain right here. Very nice. Alright guys, that's gonna do it for the video. I wanted to make a goal of going from the top of downtown Dunedin to the very end, which is right here at the park, the pier or the marina, and show you guys a little bit of sights and sounds of Dunedin, especially this time of year. But very nice town to enjoy right here on the Gulf Coast, and lots of history here too also. So definitely check it out. Follow me on my channel, like and subscribe if you like this video, and I will do more places around Florida. But definitely just get out and explore whenever you can and enjoy what is there is to offer all around you. And I will see you guys later. You guys stay safe, take care, and see you guys later. Take care.